improve the socio-economic condition of the most disfavored in society. I'm talking about the persistent levels of poverty that you find here in this country. There are a lot of poor people who don't have freedom and who don't have the minimal means to meet their needs. And that, I hope, can be turned around in the coming short and medium term, so that the country can become more prosperous. In addition, regional cooperation, the European perspective, good governance, fiscal discipline, all these issues need to be consistently avoided. That would be my statement.
We have a question on the student all day.
This might be a little bit, not really off topic.
Don't let Mike on, please.
But it's an important question nonetheless. What do you think about the Albenkurte case? Like, is it righteous or fair, drawing attention to yesterday's incident, for example?
I will ask the question before the camera starts. The rule of law means that everybody has to answer to the court for his misdeeds. And Alvin Korte also has to answer for what he has done.
What has he done?
And it is, in my view, not acceptable for a responsible citizen to cause potential harm to police officers like happened yesterday. These a few police officers, as understood, got hurt in irresponsible behavior. Now, your question is this the high priority? Shouldn't we attend to other issues than to Alvin Korte? And here is where you have to understand where the arm of justice is not held by the Prime Minister or by me. It is the prosecutors, the judges, who want to bring cases where there are indictments to the court, where they have a convincing case to convince the judges that people have to be sentenced. And Alvin Korte is not going to escape justice.
More questions on students?
Yes.
In the back there, please stand up. Because we don't see your head. Speak up.
My name is Jasmine Fernandez. And you are just saying that no one is going to escape the justice. We have seen that the Romanian police just escaped 2 weeks ago. Without comporting with the law of Kosovo, to be here, the corruption. How can you explain that?
Well, this
just
for
sent home, just like that.
Yeah. I think I can refer to what Commission Pieter Feith said about this. This is clearly an unacceptable development, and it has led to sanctions being taken. The officers in charge have left Kosovo. The sending state will take responsibility and take action where appropriate. And this is simply something that should not happen again. The rule of law mission is here to help strengthen the rule of law. And therefore, we have to expect, rightly, you have to expect, that members of such a mission are respectful of the rule of law themselves.
Next, anybody have a question?
This is very surprising to me that there are so few questions from our students, but I hope that's a tribute to your talk. People were impressed, I was. I did omit, when introducing you, to also recognize one very good friend of AUK who is here in the audience with us. We are Mikoshi now, the new Minister of Health in the government. We are welcome back to AUK. Pieter, I am extremely grateful to you. I think all of Kosovo is actually very grateful to you for your personal role within the international institutions. You you're in a prominent position for which people will often look to you to take the blame or to take the responsibility for many, many things. But you are well known as a friend of Kosovo, and you're working, moving Kosovo forward to its European future, something we all have.